We've been talking about developing a practical spiritual life for people, even as they live in this real world. Real quick, Disciple Makers training course quickly filling. If you're interested, please, you need to go ahead and enroll. We will be starting another course in either July or August, depending on how well this goes, and we'll start to begin to expand the number of people in the courses. We talked about this process, that it's not just praying in tongues, it's not just being used in the manifestation gifts of tongues and interpretation of tongues, prophecy, that is going to help people to be reflected or regarded as spiritual. But they're going to be people who have a personal devotion, and number two, they're part of a church that has a sustainable prayer program that is consistent. And I talked about how you can do that, and of course, churches of different sizes would have different approaches toward their prayer program. But one of the things that I feel needs to be added into this is that we need to lead our people to do service for the kingdom of God that uses their motivational gifts in a meaningful way. If the church is a body, then every member in that body should be a participating member. No onlookers. We should all be participating, doing something for God. A healthy church doesn't have many spectators. Instead, it has people participating. They're involved. They're not up in the stands. And in order to get that accomplished, it takes repeated, sustained effort. For years, I've used this series called Fitly Framed that takes people through this process from the book of Romans and helps them discover their motivational gift as well as their passion. And then we try to put it into place and help them to find a spot where that they correctly and in an adequate fashion, they do something. Well, to accomplish that, I can't just teach it one time. And this is where I think a lot of us have difficulty. We feel like we can teach something or we can address something one time and it's going to take care of it. But the truth of the matter is that you have to say important things repeatedly, including the things that we say about serving God. My approach to getting people involved in meaningful service that use their motivational gifts is that each year we would take several services. I would teach, I would preach about being motivated to serve God, to do something, and then we would have a job fair, and people would register and enroll to be part of a team doing various roles of ministry on behalf of the kingdom of God, and then we'd do it again the next year, and the next, and the next. And as time went by, we had more and more people get involved in serving the kingdom of God. As they would get involved, they begin to feel good about themselves. They begin to feel good about their relationship with God. They begin to feel better about the church that they are part of. This is an important thing. If we want our people to be spiritual, they have to be integrated into the church. They have to be woven into the fabric of the church. They can't be spectators. They can't be onlookers. They have to be participants. And getting them to be participants is my responsibility. I can't just wait on who's the most aggressive and who will volunteer. I have to be intentional about getting them engaged and involved in a way that makes a difference for the body of Christ using what they particularly have. All right? You can do it. You have questions? Send me a note. I'll be glad to do what I can to help. God bless. See you next week.